Hi, folks. It's Bill from AT Makers, and today I'm going to give you a quick update on Miss Ella Hunt. Now, many of you will remember Ella from the Engineering Ella project that we did about 4 years ago with Penn High School Robotics in Mishawaka, Indiana. Ella has spinal muscular atrophy, or SMA, which is a degenerative muscle disorder. And when we met her, she could move just two switches, one on each hand. So we created a device that let her drive her power chair with just those two pieces of input. As you can see in the video, she did great with those. She rocked. The kids from Penn helped her and gave her a space to practice. And over the years, we've been able to do other projects with Ella to help her do gaming with the Xbox Adaptive Controller, control her PC, and even work her speech-generating device using the same switches. Now, the reason for this update is that about a month ago, Ella went in for a spinal fusion surgery. Unfortunately, everything went wrong in that surgery. She had a significant bleeding event, lost a colossal amount of blood, and was in dire straits, really gave us all a good solid scare for a couple days. Good news is Ella came out with all of her personality and all of the joy that she has in life. It did not impact her cognitive abilities at all. Unfortunately, it caused two significant issues. The first being her inability to feel from the waist down, the chest down, and also the inability to move the two switches that she had. Now, it's hard to overstate how big of a problem this is. Ella uses those switches for most of the freedoms that she has, she uses those switches to get. And we decided we were going to reach out and ask the Hunts if we could come up and try to find some replacement for the switches that she used. Over the next week, I got ideas from around the country, everything from LiDAR sensors to different types of relays and FSRs and all kinds of sensors we could use. And all of them were possibilities. We didn't know which ones were gonna work. So I assembled a kit. I went up to Elkhart, Indiana last week and was able to sit with Ella and try out a whole lot of things to see if any of them were going to work. Thankfully, I was not alone. Judy Schoonover, a longtime friend of ours and a kind of world-renowned occupational therapist, was able to come down from Michigan and meet me. And we spent the afternoon with Ella trying different sensors, different positions, talking to her about what she wanted to do going forward, what her priorities were. It's kind of a great day. The first solution we came up with was based on a strain gauge sensor made by Dmitry Votenchev from Google. It's part of his Mimosa project, and we'll have links available to that as well. But it basically detects tiny changes in pressure across a strain gauge that is put on the PCB board. The second is much simpler. It's actually just an infrared sensor from Adafruit, the VCNL4040, that's able to detect minute motions of her cheek and give her the ability to activate a switch based on when she moved the corner of her mouth. So we spent the afternoon with a system that allowed Ella to actually see what the sensors were detecting and help us position things, whether it was on her cheek or on her hand, so that she had the most amount of control. But I'd show you a little bit of that video here.
But currently it is looking at Ella's cheek, and when she smiles, yay, it gives enough of a difference that we can see it here. There it was.
Once we knew what we were going to use, we had to get it set up and tuned correctly. So I went down to Indianapolis, where Chris Young lives. He helped me both by being a guinea pig and by writing most of the software that controlled the switches and basically turned the basic measurements we could get out of her intent, into the activation we wanted, which in this case was a basic AT switch activation. Hi, here's a look at the first time Ella used the switch with her iPad.
Hi, everybody. Hi. So, this is the second switch, which we have on a tray. And Chris Young and I made you that neat holder. Does it work? Can you control it really well? Look at that. And your finger's hardly moving, but it works, right? All right, so that goes into a little microcontroller relay, which comes out and goes into her iPad. And now check it out. She's like a pro with the iPad again.
She's gonna move that little guy or some other part. Yep. Pick your location. Where are you going to put him? In the shower?
Right there?
Where are you putting him?
Look at that. How cool is that? You're dragging things on your iPad. And she's been using this for like what?
Couple years.
2 minutes? No, this switch.
No, I was going to say
this right switch. Now. 2 minutes?
This switch is 2 minutes.
So this actually uses all the muscle memory you have. It's just lighter than a light touch switch, right? Does it feel the same as it used to?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So Ella is using her new switch that fabulous Dimitri came up with. And of course, Bill and crew were able to stabilize it here on her bedside. She's also using it on her chair.
Oh. Thank you for coming to help me with my switch. It made me feel happy.
That is so great, Ella. It made all of us feel happy.
Now, as bad as this situation was, I really couldn't be much happier with how the AT Makers community responded. We got help from around the world. Dozens of people offered to send us either software or hardware. The ideas we got were fantastic. So thank you to all of you. Specifically, obviously, to Dmitry Votenchev and Judy Schoonover, Alyssa Wern, all the folks at Adafruit, without whose devices we wouldn't be able to do any of this. And this time I want to add a little list of companies here. I don't always think to do this, but these are the companies that actually pay their employees to support assistive technology projects. So whether it's Microsoft or Google, Makers Making Change, LessonPix, my company, or Adafruit, these folks actually see the value in custom assistive technology and makers making it and are willing to put their money where their mouth is. So thank you. I hope you enjoyed this update. I certainly enjoyed making it and doing it. We've needed some good news over the past few months, and I'm glad to share some. I hope you join us. I hope to see you in the future. And as always, good luck and have fun.
And Merry Christmas, right? Santa Bill. Coming down the chimney.